Sometimes you want to automate things in Orchard. A very simple example that we'll also look into would be to display a message to the user based on certain scenarios. But we can talk about more complex things as well, like when a content item is saved, then invoke a webhook remotely to send a message somewhere. And of course, you can do everything from code. If you create your own module, then you can do whatever is possible in C Sharp. But there is also a feature in Orchard that makes this easy and from the admin without coding, which is called workflows. So let's see workflows in action. What we'll do now is that we'll display a message when the user saves a content item, and that message will contain the user's name. By doing that, we also see another small example of Liquid markup and how Liquid can be used to create dynamic texts, dynamic pieces of texts in Orchard. The workflows feature is not enabled by default in the blog recipe, so we will have to enable it. And as you can see, the workflows module has several features. One for example, invoking webhooks that I said. One for timers too. So workflows always start with some kind of event. So something happens and then the workflow starts. And mid-workflow, you can also pause the workflow and wait for something to happen. And that something can either be something that the user does, like clicking a button, saving a content item, something else that happens in the system, or simply a timer, like run this every 5 minutes. That's quite useful. Yeah, so just to keep it simple, let's enable everything here. I won't need to enable the base workflows feature because due to dependencies, that will be automatically enabled when I enable the two features that it actually depends on, or that actually depend on it. And now we have the workflows menu item here, and we can start creating workflow types. So let's actually do that. So again, this workflow will be about displaying a message to the user when they save a content item, so I will just call it thank you. We can also enable and disable a workflow. Workflows are not content items, so you can't unpublish it to make it disabled of that sort. You can disable it with this configuration. Single instance and delete successfully completed workflows are sometimes useful too. Single instance, so we are creating a workflow type here. When something starts this workflow type, then a workflow instance will be created. And we can have multiple instances. So if two users will save a content item at the same time, then at that time there will be multiple instances of this workflow running. We can restrict the workflow to just a single instance, and this is useful if it's about some user interaction, because well, why would you restrict the number of instances there? This is sometimes useful for automatically started workflows. And delete successfully completed workflows is about cleaning up the log, basically. So again, what the workflow is that is actually running, the instance of this workflow type. And if you don't check this, then you will be able to see which workflows run recently. Let's leave everything like this so we can see it in action. Let's save it. And the next thing is that we can actually create this workflow. And workflows are about pretty much automatic a lot of tasks from the admin, and it's basically visual programming. So you hook things together here without coding. And we get a nice canvas here that we can start adding events and tasks to. Now, as I mentioned, workloads always start with some kind of event because there needs to be a beginning. So let's start with an event. And again, we have such a nice long list in this grid layout, which is which might be an indication that this is always an extensible UI. So all these events are coming from different places. They are actually coming from a variety of modules. So the workflow module doesn't contain workflow events for content, for example. All these content-related events here come from the contents module, because modules can integrate like this. And again, Orchard is well modularized, and these features are nicely extensible. So you can also add your own workflow events or tasks from your own module. And as you can see, there are a lot of these events. We have a lot for content-related events. HTTP request you can use to start a workflow with an HTTP request. So previously I said that from a workflow you can call a webhook. It's also possible to start a workflow via a webhook too. So this is useful for integrating with external systems. You can set this up that if something happens in an external system, then it will call a webhook in your Orchard application and start a workflow. We also have user-related events, which are also coming, not from the workflows module, but from the users module. And there are a lot of other events, also timer, as I said. But for now, let's focus on content, and let's select content published. So the user will receive a message when a content item is published. And not just any content item, but let's stick to blog post still. Yeah, and optionally we could add a title to this event, but that's not really necessary now. And an important thing is that it's not just enough to add this event to this workflow, but rather you also have to set it as the start of this workflow with this button here. And now this means that this workflow will be started when this event is fired. Yeah, we have now an event, that's good, but let's also do something. And for that, we have tasks. So there are always events that start a workflow or start some process, and there are tasks that actually do that process. And we have a lot of tasks here too, again, coming from a variety of modules. We have everything related to users, contents, other tasks. It's, as I said, it's visual, it's kind of visual programming. So there are also, you can also write or create conditions. You can also write or create loops here. And you can also display notifications or write an entry to the log file. So let's display a notification that will be suitable for now. And again, we can give a title to this notification, and we can specify a notification type. If you remember, sometimes we have seen green and yellow bubbles of text above here. Those are using the same notification infrastructure. Luckily, we haven't seen any red one. That would be the error. For now, let's keep it as success, since when the user does something and we want to thank them, well, I would call that a success. And here we can have some message too. And this this is not just a simple static message, but or static text, but as you can see, we can again use liquid markup here. And what you can do in liquid is, of course, documented. There are a lot of things. Well, first of all, liquid itself is not Orchard specific. So as you can see from this documentation page in the Orchard documentation site, there is a lot more information to get when you are reading about general liquid stuff. But specific to Orchard, there is a lot of things there. This is well documented, a lot of documentation, a lot of examples, a lot of things here. And there are also things related to the user. Well, a lot of things, as you can see. And for example, if you also have a tag corresponding or for the user, where we can display their name. So that's what we'll actually do. So we'll display a message, something like thank you. And now will come the user's name. And as we can also see from the documentation, we are now under under the user tag, and the name is identity.name. So if we want it in full, then we will write user.identity.name. You might notice that identity.name is something familiar. It indeed comes from, again, from the ASP.NET Core authentication infrastructure. So we are actually accessing the ASP.NET user object here. And that's it. Yeah, we can actually go back and add an exclamation mark to cheer the user up a bit. And now we have these two things here. The last thing remaining is to connect them. And that's where the visual programming comes. You drag an arrow from the outcome of an event or a task, and you drag it to the next task. And that's how you do it. Sometimes tasks or events have multiple outcomes, like the if-else one has an if and an else one, but the content published event just has a single outcome, which is done. So that's what we'll use. And let's hit save. All right, now we are done here. Let's actually do something with our already existing blog post and let's see whether it works. Yeah, nothing really necessary here. I will just hit publish and the nice message is displayed. Thank you, admin. So that's pretty good that it works. And now we can go back to our workflow. And once I refresh, we'll see that we have one workflow here. And this is where you can list the workflows. So again, what we have created on the canvas and everything, that's called a workflow type. And here we see the actual workflows, the workflow instances. And well, this instance of this workflow ran pretty quickly. So it's as you can see, is already finished. And we can see some details about it here too. This was, of course, a very simple workflow. So you can have workflows that wait for days based on a timer or based on some user input. In that case, you will see that workflow listed here, but it won't, of course, be finished. And remember about cleaning up the configuration, about cleaning up completed workflows, why we see it here, despite it being finished and long gone, is because we didn't opt to clean it up, because I wanted to show it to you. And this is the basics of workflows and Liquid. And of course, do check out the documentation here, because there is a lot of information here that you can check out, a lot more details. I just wanted to show you that this is another feature that Orchard has. So if you are thinking about automating something, you might not want to start with code, because it can be much simpler, much quicker to just throw a workflow together from the admin, hit save, and now you have that task automated.